3 hours in and far from over. You're looking at live video as hundreds pack the Civic Center wanting to make their 2 cents count on the mayor's budget. Our live team coverage begins tonight with KETV News Watch 7's Ryan Luby. Ryan?
Yeah, Rob, I tell you, a tax increase was absolutely the hot topic of discussion here tonight. Nearly each person that walked up to the podium had something to say about taxes. The vast majority say they do not support either the entertainment tax proposal or the property tax proposal. Let's look at some video. In fact, taxpayers from Freedom, as we told you at 6, hosted a tea party outside of the city-county building. Inside, at the meeting, Nebraska Taxpayers for Freedom President Doug Kagan presented council members with 1,000 or more signatures his people collected from people who say they just do not support a tax increase in any way. But I tell you, there were some people here, namely the OTOC folks, who say they do support a tax increase to balance out the city's budget. Let's listen to what some of these people had to say.
We feel it is misguided and counterproductive to simply cut services to balance the budget.
We especially believe anything done in haste will have long-term consequences and will become an even bigger barrier to creating jobs and attracting new businesses.
Because I try to motivate people to exercise, but I must be doing it wrong. Because you guys are telling me it's entertaining for people to walk on a treadmill, and you're going to tax them. But it's not entertaining to go to a concert at Mecca.
By the way, there are a good number of people here tonight also concerned about cuts of city employees. And KETV News Watch 7's Farah Fazal is here to tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, Ryan, we heard from several civilian city employees tonight. 45 full-time city workers would be laid off if the mayor's budget is passed.
We are important employees of the city, and we continue to be asked to take cuts and to lose our jobs to support and help out the city.
Today I had the really hard day watching 55 of my fellow employees be told that they were going to be let go.
I've been doing the same thing for 21 years. Now I'm going to have to be going to a library and bumping somebody out of a job, which I hate. I hate putting anybody out of a job.
The mayor says the cuts and the layoffs are absolutely necessary to make up $9 million of a $12 million shortfall, Rob.
All right, Farah Fazal and Ryan Luby reporting live. Thank you both. Earlier today, the city council got an earful from taxpayers worried about paying more for entertainment. The proposal would add a 2% tax everywhere from restaurants to movies to bowling. All nonprofits, though, are now exempt, including Mecca, which runs the Quest Center.
We appreciate that, and they've included us now. But that being said, you know, we stand with our hospitality partners. I mean, we want to do what's right for the community. We're not sure that this entertainment tax is the right way to go.
Council members introduced 8 amendments, everything from lowering the tax to 1% or raising it to 5%. Another would exclude health and fitness clubs as well as the nonprofits.